In this video, we are going to discuss the DC analysis of MOSFET circuits. And the first thing to notice about the MOSFET is that the gate is always open circuit in the DC analysis, which means that the current of the gate always equals zero. And this will make our solutions much easier than the solutions of the bipolar junction transistor. Because in the bipolar junction transistor, we had three currents, I base, I collector, I emitter. But here we have only one current, the current between the drain and source. While the current I gate is always zero. This is because the gate, there is an insulation between the gate and the body of the transistor. This makes the DC current of the gate equals zero. This will make the solution much easier than the case of the bipolar junction transistor. And then, to summarize what we said before, we have two important regions of operations. Either the transistor is going to operate in the triode region or the saturation region, or it will be cut off, right? So in order for the transistor to be on, you need VGS, the voltage between the gate and the source, to be greater than or equal to V threshold. And then if it is on, then it can be saturation or triode, right? And in order for the transistor to be saturation, you need VDS to be greater than VGS minus V threshold, or you can write the same condition in other words, that VGD is less than V threshold. And in order for the transistor to work in the triode region, you need VDS to be less than or equal. The equal sign is a critical point. It can be considered as saturation of triode. So we need in the triode VDS to be less than VGS minus V threshold. Or you can write the same condition in another form, which is VGD greater than V threshold. VGD greater than V threshold means that the channel is open towards the drain. The channel is open, so we are in the triode. Here, the channel will be closed towards the drain, and hence we are in the pinch off or the saturation. So the pinch off is the same as the saturation. So this is usually the condition that we use, but sometimes we need to, or it's easier to use this condition to know whether the transistor will be saturation or triode. Okay, so if you want to start solving a DC analysis of a MOSFET circuit, usually we don't know the status of the transistor, so we usually assume solve check, the same procedure that we used with the diode with the bipolar junction transistor. Assume solve check. Usually here we start by assuming saturation. Why? Because saturation is easier to solve. So it will not take time. If you assume that the transistor is saturation, it will not take you time to solve the problem, and then you check. But if you start by assuming triode, the solution will be longer, and then at the end, you might discover that you did something or the assumption was wrong, and you wasted a lot of time solving for the triode, and you have to repeat for the saturation. So it's better always to start with the saturation, and then if it is wrong, you go to the triode. Huh? You didn't lose a lot of time here, but if you start with the triode, you will lose a lot of time. Okay? So if you start by assuming saturation, so by default, you can use the equation of the saturation, the current in the saturation. You can use the equation of the current in the saturation, which is Kn over 2, the constant Kn over 2, VGS minus V threshold squared. And if you include the channel length modulation, you have to multiply by 1 plus lambda VDS. But if the problem didn't mention anything about lambda, or it said that lambda equals 0, then you ignore this part of the channel length modulation. And then at the end, after you solved your problem, you have to check. How do you check for the saturation? You have to check for this condition, that VDS is greater than or equal VGS minus V threshold. And then, if you want to assume triode, then you can use the equation of the current in the triode. The equation of the current in the triode is Kn VGS minus V threshold minus VDS over 2 multiplied by VDS. And at the end, you need to check for the condition of the triode, which is VDS less than or equal VGS minus V threshold. Okay, so here, this is what you can use and how to check. Usually, if you have a DC circuit, a DC MOSFET circuit, usually what you do is you start with the gate source loop. So you start with the gate source loop in order to calculate the voltage VGS. You do KVL in this loop, you calculate VGS. And then from VGS, you can calculate the current. After you calculate the current, IDS, the current between the drain and source, you move to the loop between the drain and source. So usually we start with this loop between the gate and source. You apply KVL here, you calculate VGS. After you calculate VGS, you move to the other loop between the drain and source in order to calculate VDS. And once you have VDS and VGS, you can do the check whether you are in the saturation or in the triode. Sometimes you need, it's not direct to find VGS by one equation from here, by applying KVL here to find VGS directly. Sometimes it's not that easy. Sometimes, for example, if you have a resistance here connected to the source, then calculating, for example, something like this, then calculating VGS will depend on the current here, with the current IDS. But the current IDS depends on VGS, so you will have to solve two equations together in order to find the current and to find VGS together. So sometimes you need to apply KVL here. In addition to the equation of the current, you will have two equations in two variables, VGS and IDS. You solve them together in order to find VGS and IDS. Then you move to the other loop between the drain and source, and you apply KVL to it in order to find VDS. Also, if that transistor is in the triode region, because the equation of the current depends on VGS and VDS, you might need to solve sometimes three equations together. You might need to solve the KVL of this loop, KVL of this loop, in addition to the current equation, in order to obtain all the voltages required. So this is basically the procedure that we'll follow, and it's better to see this procedure using examples. First, you start by the gate source loop, then the drain source loop. First, you start by assuming saturation. If this is wrong, you move to assuming triode. So here, in the next video, we are going to start with the first example, and we'll see how to apply this procedure on different exams. See you in the next video.